The following presentation does not represent Australian opinion or intellect. We do not speak for any religious order or ethnic minority. We are not political scientists or uni graduates. We're insignificant upper lower class scum, comparing notes and airing grievances. It's just our opinion. Deal with it.
So GST will ever be part of our policy.
Never ever.
It's dead.
If they don't like it, go back to where they're from.
It is a big idea.
No, we don't need them.
A new world order. By 1990, no Australian child will be living in poverty.
You should shell out.
Yes, I thought you just open it and guzzle it.
No, you have to aerate it.
Is that with like anyone you want to?
Yeah,
like,
anyone.
Goombag.
And the rule of thumb.
The
rule of thumb is you aerate it an hour per year that it's made. So if it's a 2016, then you'd aerate it for 2 hours.
What's aerate? I don't understand.
So it's just where the air
I wonder
can
if that's
get...
on the coaster as well.
The bottle of wine is on the coaster.
The bottle of wine is on the coaster.
But yes, the glass is,
is for us and the bottle of wine is for her.
Yeah.
Guys, I need nuts.
But you have to explain aerating.
Okay, yeah, so what's aerating?
Do you put it in something or you just...
No. So have you heard of decanters?
Yeah, like I've got some for whiskey
wine.
And stuff.
Yeah, so yeah. It's the same sort of concept.
Okay.
You know,
is it what? You pour it into another holder.
Yep, and let the air get to it.
Is that why would I have that here?
Isn't this a wedding joint company?
Next to the silver.
Surely.
Why would a wedding place have an aerator?
You'd have a decanter on there. No,
but
wouldn't.
We don't offer the alcohol. Like, they supply the alcohol and we just provide the service.
Yeah. The caterers.
Got it.
Yeah.
You don't know the difference between an event hire company and a caterer?
I do, but I just didn't know exactly what he did.
Look around you, dude. The stock.
Yeah. But he has
I'm a schmuck. It's just a chump. It's just a fucking minion.
I need one of these. I'm fucking dying.
You want one?
How are you?
Oh, yeah.
How are we?
Tripsels?
Oh, sick.
How are we?
You still
I'm still
sick?
Fucking sick. Because I went back. I've switched my hours up again. Actually, hang on.
That was a quick think.
No.
No, I don't
let
think
me
it's
think.
No. I'm trying to think of which one it is.
It's
the picnic one, the bears.
Huh?
The bears. We're going on a bear hunt. We're going on a bear hunt. You know?
Huh?
We're going to catch a big one. We're going to catch a
sorry,
big
where
one.
I grew up, I
I'm
didn't have
not scared.
And stuff.
I'm not scared. You know?
Oh, I've never heard of that.
Dude, I remember that because I remember...
And you get like the bear that scares you.
Do you know why? I remember the white kids singing that at kindergarten and I was like...
I've never heard of that.
I'd never heard it before and I felt really awkward singing that shit.
So just a nursery rhyme. Just a, like a...
Yeah.
I think probably because I grew up hunting. By six, I'd already been hunting with my old man.
So when you speak about bears and like
so you're
stuff,
you're just
you
like just... going the fucker.
Dude, well,
he doesn't scare me.
I'm gonna take this bear out.
This is a legitimate question. At what age do we stop singing nursery rhymes to kids?
I reckon by the time the kid gets into prep,
do you stop at prep?
No.
Because even kids,
how old are the kids?
Not necessarily,
that you watch?
But yeah, up to kinder. Not necessarily, it depends on the child, but it just changes in prep because there's a lot more storytelling.
Books get
you
read,
might, yeah,
story
and
time.
you might sing something to get them to the floor, like a transition sort of song. To get them to clean.
Metallica.
Actually Metallica, man.
Special guest James Hetfield.
Yeah. Dude, get it from the floor.
Do you know what I've done, though? Like, just to
I
make
brought
it.
My uncle in for show and tell. What's his name?
Marilyn Manson.
Just comes in. He comes in, makeup, full fucking... That'd be fucking awesome. But...
I've, to make it more interesting for myself, I've sometimes incorporated, like, made up my own transition song.
For yourself?
But to make it interesting for myself, because I hate that shit. But, you know, I'm all animated.
Then why are you working with kids?
Well, because you need these tools sometimes to connect with them and get them to do certain things and set boundaries and whatnot. You know, you need to connect with them on their level. For me, I'm losing brain cells. So I have to, like, you know...
You make up your own kind of...
Yeah, like, or like, I'll do like Michael Jackson, you know, Rock With You, and I'm like, we're going to clean today.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
Oh, like, so you reappropriate songs and then just change
the words. I make them up for like, say, we're going to clean or whatever.
Yeah.
And just like use a tune I like, and it's so catchy. Like, they love
it. If they've got a task to do, you just sing it to them in a way that... Yeah.
And it works. I'm just like...
You got to sing Disposable Teens.
You were hard to see, man.
Back in black! Blast.
Start with AC/DC.
Back to the tables.
They're just Pantera Cowboys from Hell. Actually, that's a song. How do you reckon...
Oh.
No. How do you reckon a kid would react... Because you remember you said there was that YouTube video about the kids listening to Metallica.
It react, yeah.
Yeah.
And some kids were like, I like watching that stuff to see different reactions of kids.
Yeah.
As in to music that we grew up with.
Mm.
Some kids were like, going, this is cool.
Mm.
And the other kid was like, I don't know what they're saying. It's scaring me. It's like, dude, relax, only Metallica.
Yeah. Imagine that. Like, no, I would have definitely been one of those kids.
Man, I would have put on Cradle of Filth.
I also think it's what they've grown up with. Like, if they've heard that around the house, if they've heard rock and stuff, then would they be more comfortable?
Dimebag, man.
First day of prep. Hi, my name is Mr. Petroglou.
Hey, my kid's going to school with this, man, with headphones on, listening to Pantera.
What?
What a track.
Sultana. Is this so bad?
Do you want to wait for the verse?
Yeah, I don't. It's going to spoil it.
It's Pantera, man.
I'm broken.
Oh, dude, best track ever. Actually, how would you handle that? I mean, that's not a question for Nick. How would you handle that if your kid came home and was like asking to listen to metal? Yeah, zero eyes.
No. I'll seize, and then I'll just try to understand why he's asking that and why he's interested in it. It's not that I'm going to say no, like that's the devil's music.
It could be. It could be interested in the instruments. It could be interested.
Like that's interesting because it wouldn't be playing in my household. So my curiosity would stem from oh yeah, cool. Where have you heard it? Do you like it? What do you like about it? I just would try to understand what he's coming from.
Dude, I legit remember being in year 7, year 8, and not just Metallica. It's when Slipknot first came out. Mm. I'd be listening to Slipknot. My grandmother would come in. What fucking kind of demonic shit are you listening to?
My best friend
loved
it.
That was pretty bad. The first Slipknot album was
and I hated it.
Mm.
It was just not my stuff.
Actually, that's a question. Malika, did you ever cop flack for listening to Tupac or Ice Cube or anything in your house?
Nah.
Did your mum ever care?
Mm.
Did your parents ever care?
No, but if she heard things, she'd be like, oh, long gone are the days of the Sound of Music, aren't they?
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
You actually grew up in that house?
Yeah, this is why I love the Sound of Music and everything theatrical.
Never watched it.
No.
I don't think I've ever seen it all the way through.
As in, I've seen clips. I've seen clips and stuff like that.
But I'm kind of well-rounded in that sense. I just, not metal.
I'm just saying, because
I've grown up with a lot of music.
But I appreciate all music, though. Yeah. It takes talent to play music. Simple as that.
Jazz is one of my favorites, and that's an art. That's an art.
I could sit there and listen to a symphony, man. Because I love.
Oh my god, me too.
But that's what I'm saying. But then the next song on my playlist really would be a Korn song.
Yeah.
Or
Rammstein.
Davies.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
No, that's interesting. The only reason why I'm asking is because I'm remembering growing up, and I listened to Tupac and all that shit. Pretty much not in secret, but parents didn't venture into my room to find out what I was listening to. It was quiet.
Why? Why did you listen to it in secret? Did you feel like...
Have you ever heard the opening line to West Side Connection, Bow Down?
My mum wouldn't even if she heard it, it's like background music until there was a clear kind of profanity.
Oh, dude, your mum would have lost it if
but
she heard
But you know, what's
Cube,
that dizzle?
Natural Born Killers?
Oh, Snoop Dogg? No, that song. When I met you last night, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and a fun.
Now, come on. My mum would be like... My brother came home and was listening to that, and I heard the melody, and I was like, this is cool. And then I was listening to it, I'm like,
when I met you last night,
do you understand
baby?
What they're saying? He loved it.
Boy, you opened up your gap.
So bad.
I had respect for your lady.
Now I take it all back.
What a knob. Like, that song's, like, I like the melody. Yeah. But what a knob for singing that shit.
Dude, that
fuck
was a Clayton anthem.
Dude, that's Nate Dogg, man, and all that kind that, of, those, that, all those West
every
Coast.
House party there, growing man. Up. That
no,
was the one that
and then he goes,
everyone.
And I
never met a girl.
Dude, we know, everyone in Clayton knows that song.
I love.
I'm pretty sure it's the word. It's not just Clayton.
No, but as in, that was a house party staple for us growing up.
Give a fuck yeah. about a bitch.
I liked I Too Close. Next. Huh? Next, Too Close.
Next episode.
Next.
Oh, the band the Next. Band. Yeah, I remember Next.
Yeah,
Next.
Too Close.
Weren't they like a pop?
R&B.
R&B. Yeah. Yeah.
Dude, this is the opening line. I've said it before in this podcast about what we're listening to, and this is literally grade 6 anthem. No, no, no. You remember...
I remember Pony. That was like grade 5.
Yeah. Genuine.
Yeah.
Genuine.
Genuine. That was a... Dude, that's a yeah, strip. Man. Oh, the no. whole clip has got those baggy jeans and his dad's out.
Dude, I gave some bean on shit one day in music class. I pissed him off. He threw me out.
I rode a bull to that song. Huh? I rode a mechanical bull to that song. Yes.
Are you, where did you find the mechanical bull?
In America.
Again, ACDC.
In
this, in the, yeah. Shook me all night long.
In the Saddle Ranch in LA. And I literally was like one of the last people to ride this bull. They could not get me off. I was wearing denim shorts, right? Do you know what happened? He tipped the bull forward. So I couldn't do anything. Yeah. Started rattling it like this. So my ass is shaking behind me going, oh, fuck, Aurora. Dignity out the window.
Gone.
Gone. I was like,
dude, you're in LA
you.
Riding so a bull.
Just, you were riding
so
a bull.
So I just slid
yeah,
off.
Yeah, no, there's no
dignity.
It's
a genuine
there.
Pony.
This was literally what I was raised on. First elements of hip-hop, yeah? No shit. Like, I was...
The world is mine, nigga, get back. Don't fuck with my stack. The cage is wrecked.
See, I wish that I knew Black Talk. I don't understand. It's all the slang I don't get, so that's not offensive.
See,
I can't understand
we grew up watching
it.
Like gangster movies, like as in, yeah. You know, American culture, like Black American culture movies and shit.
Do you know what?
My first movie
funny?
I saw was Boys in the Hood, and I was like a kid.
Right. Yeah, that was a great movie.
I was a kid. Like, I was like 6, 7. God. And, you know, Dope
My
Boy and all that.
Jump was about the, as black as I went younger, but I,
but make it please.
Nah. I have actually taped a few of them. A friend and I were listening to Tupac. And I was talking
wait,
about.
You're gonna
very...
say it. You said Tupac.
Tupac.
Whatever.
Tupac paint, mate.
And I don't mind it. I don't mind it. I don't listen to it all the time, but I don't mind his stuff because it's melodic, and I like what. And his
look, his early stuff was crazy because he was a poet, man.
He writes
before,
well. Yeah.
Before he became full gangster.
Yeah.
He had some tracks, man.
Yeah.
It wasn't just.
Yeah. And I don't mind it anyway. But my friend like understands the lyrics and everything, knows what he's saying. I'm like, what the fuck is
dude,
he saying?
It's not even
right?
Ebonics. It's pretty articulate.
No. Like, but they use a lot of slang.
No,
right?
They don't.
Yeah, they do. And,
Park doesn't.
And
no, it doesn't.
The way that
Snoop Dogg and all that do.
The way does. That they yeah. emphasize is, no, the way that they emphasize words and stuff. Like, you've got to understand, I don't know none of it. So, like, the
she's
emphasis
on my
words,
and my kism.
I don't know what that is for sure. I don't know. Anyway, so...
blood, cuz.
She's like, all right, we're going to play a game. Like, she's like, repeat what he says. I'm like, all right. So I'm listening, like maybe a bar or something. She pauses it, and I'm just like, I repeat it, and she's like, what the fuck, dude? And I, like, it is so wrong, like how I've picked up the words. So wrong, like I've bastardized it completely, for
but
sure.
But you didn't grow up listening to it, though.
No, that's I have no idea. Like, you know Friday, yeah. the movies?
Yeah. Who
like,
doesn't
know Friday?
What the
fuck is he saying?
Really?
I don't have the ear for it. Yeah, I'm like... What can we have subtitles, please? Like, I can't understand.
It's Parker.
Miss Parker. That's Bernie Mac.
Yeah.
And he's the worst. That's the worst.
Bernie
like,
Mac.
Where it's got the type of southern twang to it, too. Yeah. I'm just like, huh?
Bernie Mac was a king. Are you
yeah, I'm not saying anything. I don't understand it because I didn't grow
how?
Up there.
Give some of my cataracts.
Chicago. It wasn't even from the south.
Give me some of my cataracts, motherfucker.
Seriously?
Seriously. We should play that game. We should play that game here. Like, play a Tupac song. Tell me to, like...
Oh, man.
Give you a bar. Like, it's hilarious. Yeah, I don't know when I come
Tupac's
up
Tupac's different. He was just... different to other rappers. He was like more of a poet, man. That guy
yeah,
could
no,
like...
Yeah, no, I know. I've read
so
some of his stuff.
So the way he came across in songs, he would actually say words properly. He wasn't like, for shiz on my diz on my niz. Like,
no, I
he wasn't
know
that. Kind
that.
Of, yeah.
But even the words, yeah, I don't understand because it's slang.
He talks about guns, he talks about things like that
my friend had to explain to me. What the fuck's a four? What the fuck's a nine? Oh,
okay, I'll get
what
you what you're saying.
All
yeah.
this stuff. Do you know what I mean?
My comrades.
I have no idea about slang, so I don't know what that is. You know, so I can maybe understand, like, I can say, like, you're nine, you're four, or whatever.
Okay, yeah, do you want to play?
But I don't, you're 48 or whatever, but I don't know. Soon as I get home. What does he say? Soon as I get home. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, baby, it's me again, stuck inside this max pen, trying to pay my debt for all my sins. This penitentiary time's been so heavy on my mind.
Penitentiary time's been so heavy on my mind, yeah?
Hell, stuck in my jail cell. County jail, waiting for my next to post bail.
I'm gonna be. Hey, large
max. Great track. I love the beat. This beat is like, this is my favorite Tupac song.
Is it?
Straight
up. Straight up.
What does he say? Grab my something, locate my Conrads. What does he say?
I'm going to get my homeboy. I'm going to get my boy.
No, but grab my what?
Okay, hang on.
Grab my jacks.
Do you want to get the lyrics?
Is that what he says? Grab my jacks, locate my Conrads.
Hang on.
Super. You and me, it's the whole world. Soon as I get home.
Oh, strap.
Strap his gun.
Right. When I'm coming back, to get the money at the safe. Time to turn the sheets into a war zone. Soon as I get home.
Okay,
I know this one.
You know this song.
I know this one.
Okay, there you go.
Okay, hang on. What lyrics would you like to decipher? Because these are pretty clear cut.
Tupac was really pretty clear cut compared to other rappers, man.
Like, okay, but when I can sort of get it. Method. Sometimes I get it.
Wu-Tang Clan.
But because I don't understand.
You have to diversify your bomb.
Because I don't understand the slang,
yeah.
It doesn't comprehend as a sentence in my mind.
Yeah,
so I'm reading these lyrics. There is almost no slang in this. I'm serious.
It's the way that he approaches the song. The way he
it's like sometimes it's the pronunciation of words that I can't understand.
Have you heard his song Dear Mama?
It's yeah, I have.
And Brenda's Got a Baby and all that kind of stuff.
Yes,
so you
yes.
know a few of his songs.
Yes, I do.
But I don't know.
Like it's the slang. Like if I haven't heard the song, I don't know the lyrics off my heart. Right, so. You know, if I try to repeat it, for me, it's like when you're talking about a nine or a four, because I don't understand what that, 48, whatever the fuck he talks about. Like, strap. Oh. I thought it was...
It's a gun.
Yeah, grab my... What is it?
That's a gun.
Huh? I forgot what I said that I thought it was, but I didn't say strap. The reason is because what the fuck is a strap? And why would I put that in
you know
a sentence?
You get it. This you know? Is what would actually trip you out. It wouldn't get you, but this would confuse you. The chorus to Still Tippin'. Slim Thug?
Yeah, they should put Twister on.
Oh, forget it.
What's Twister?
He's just like rappers of all time.
Oh, wow.
And you've got to be like, even me, like, I'm not... Like, dims into, like...
Yeah,
like,
rap. Do you know who I'm not?
I'm not that much into it. And all I can hear is... Blah, 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 catch a few words. Blah, blah, blah,
right.
Blah. I could literally break it down.
Yeah.
Like, my ear was so well trained.
Who was it? King Kunta? Who sings King Kunta?
Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, he's good. I like his style.
I don't listen to the new stuff.
Yeah, it's new. Dude, this chorus?
Tipping on ho-hos?
That, he literally says fo-fos or fo-vogues or fo-hos. Like, he has four different words that he uses there, but you wouldn't have picked up any of them.
And what the fuck does that mean?
Vogues, hires, okay. Four hoes, women.
Hoes.
Loosely scant women. Four foes, fours, as in, like, guns.
Yeah.
And what was the other one? I can't remember. I keep forgetting the last one.
See, I wouldn't even decipher that because I don't know... Mm. The words. Like
yeah, that's fair enough. That's not...
I'm like, why don't you say ties?
It doesn't sound...
Four ties. Four loosely clad women. Four guns. It just wouldn't go well.
I would love that if someone could just rewrite the lyric to proper words.
Yeah, one of his homeboys like, man, that's whack.
There's one going out to Aurora out there. You're going to be singing along when you'll get.
That's silly.
Dude, the whole reason why I even brought it up was because of
yeah, what we're talking about?
I didn't get to say it.
Nursery rhymes,
like,
what?
I kept music quiet up until probably up until, because like that's what I grew up listening to, right, at some point.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't until, and then all through like early high school, like Rage Against the Machine all that crap. But it wasn't until I got into full hip-hop swing, like 99, 2000, pretty much. Just after, like, Parker died. What had come out after that? It was, what was his first album after he died? Are You Still Down and the 7 Day Theory and all that shit. So that was,
so that was what, 98, 99 ish.
Yeah. And then Friday, Next Friday came out, so you had That Soundtrack. Yeah. And like, it was really big. And then Eminem.
Cube came out with like War and Peace or something, or Love and Peace,
then
or whatever.
The Up in Smoke Tour, that was monumental. The Up in Smoke Tour.
Everyone's got a copy of that.
Yeah, the Up in Smoke Tour was like the Woodstock.
I didn't have one. Huh? Okay.
You got to watch that DVD.
Up in Smoke had everyone. Yeah. Had like Ice Cube, Eminem, Snoop, Dre,
Nate,
Dub C,
Max. But then what? I think the question was
crazy,
why,
man.
Why did you listen to it in quiet?
Well, because my old man wouldn't understand it, because to him it just
were
be swearing.
You frightened though that they would say something?
It's funny because they wouldn't hear any other words because they wouldn't understand it, but they'd hear the fuck and the hoe, bitch, and bitch, and all that kind of stuff.
But then in 2001, when Eminem came here, a mate of mine had a ticket for sale. Yeah, Peter Thomas Promise. Yeah, his mum wouldn't let him go, you know, to Eminem's concert. So my cousin offered it to me.
Oh, nice.
And I said, "Yeah, mad, I'm coming." But then my old man arced up when he found out. Because he didn't agree with Eminem. Didn't know his music, didn't know nothing. All he saw was Eminem flipping off cameras in the media. He's like, that's rubbish, blah, blah, blah. Mm. And I lost it. And I'm like, do you even understand what that's about? And I said to him, that is in direct response to everyone who ever bullied him or doubted him.
It wasn't to, like, just everybody in public.
Literally. That is literally in response to everyone who ever doubted him or bullied him growing up.
Billy D'Angelo.
He's on top of the world. Yeah. But in contrast, my mum, who heard me listening to the Slim Shady LP, like, growing up, like, as in, when it came out, and she took the time to actually listen to the lyrics, she used to say he was a genius.
Mm-hmm, okay.
From early on. Like, I'm talking Slim Shady LP days, man. Like, what was that lyric? I lay awake and strap myself in the bed with a bulletproof vest on and shoot myself in the head.
That's a kick-ass line, because it's like
the irony.
Awesome though. Yeah.
Yeah, but the dark irony of it, and my mum got it.
Mm-hmm.
She actually understood, like, Role Model, all these songs. She actually got the irony of it, so she was fine. She's just go, like, she.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
She didn't care, and then I screwed the old man over as well when he broke down because I'd coloured my hair when I turned 18.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like 6 months later, I remember looking at the paper or something, and it was like 50 best artists of all time, or like captivating images through history or some shit. And there was a photo of Bob Dylan with like a blue streak of hair.
Yeah.
So I pulled out the paper, shown it to the old man. Like, I just left it in the living room. Cause there's your hero, Bob Dylan, man, blue hair. What the fuck's that about? They just went quiet, didn't say nothing.
It's true, though.
No, it's seriously, they forget.
They listen to David Bowie. That guy was all sorts of fucking out there.
Dude, the Stones.
Yeah, man.
The Stones. The Beatles.
Jagger.
Yeah. Jagger's. Dude. The
Not
Beatles.
My parents. No. No. It was, you know, jazz, symphony, opera. My mum, anyway. And my dad was Italian music, Italian folk, tango.
And
yeah.
And Megadeth.
Oh, but you know what my dad did love? Tell you though, you know the 90s dance music, like we were talking about?
It's the rhythm of the night.
Yeah, he loved it. He would crank it up.
LaBouche and all that?
Yeah, LaBouche. He loved
it. I was listening to LaBouche on the way.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, he really loved that.
But hang on, wait a second. How old were your parents? Like, how old was your man when he came here?
17.
Okay, so he was around the same age as my old man.
17, yeah, and he was up in Queensland for like 4 years. Yeah.
Wow.
He was up in Queensland and he didn't get into like the Stones or the Beatles or like just Brock.
No.
But that would have been all surfy, hippie culture.
No, and like honestly, back in those days, the Diegos, they stuck to themselves. They were
all the
ones
stuck
a lot.
Together.
Like,
the
yeah, like they
actually
had their own.
That
sort
makes
of,
sense because my old man hates like Greeks.
Right.
Like he hates Greeks hard.
Okay.
Yeah. So when he came, he did his best to assimilate.
Yeah.
Like he's still.
See, my dad wasn't that.
Yeah. See,
like, was very Italian.
Like
culture.
We had Greek music and stuff, and like I went to Greek school, like did all the random crap.
Mm.
But the first bits of music I ever listened to, man, was if it wasn't like Michael Jackson and all that shit, then it was literally the Stones, Dire Straits. You know, Elvis,
Michael Jackson, Beatles. Elvis. That was always around.
Dude, the Beatles have a song called Norwegian Wood.
Oh my God, Peter Andre in our household, shit.
Are you serious?
My brother.
Oh, that's right. You were telling us last time.
Yeah, like, because he sounded like Michael Jackson. I mean, and my brother loved Michael Jackson.
You think Peter Andre sounds like Michael Jackson?
He sounded like him.
How?
Yeah. No, like, when I say, like, is it falsetto? Like that sort of.
When you hit high notes.
Yeah, like that kind of thing. That high. Like Prince was the same. You know, it was all kind of that range.
Prince was in his own.
Yeah, but Prince is his own.
I'm not
man.
Comparing them. Fuck. Shit. It's pipe down. But yeah, like it's just. Yeah, I love that song.
Prince is amazing, man. I love Prince, man.
Yeah.
Really?
Prince had some cool. Good. You know why though?
I love Prince. I'm just saying. I'm trying to picture the house.
Oh yeah, yeah. Why I like Prince? I mentioned it last time with Alex and stuff. I just that guy was the smoothest motherfucker.
And I was big Mariah Carey fan, like huge.
What music box?
No, like
glitter.
like emotions. Yeah. No, it was before that. Emotions. You know, like Someday. Emotions. That,
wait,
those.
How early was that?
Like, it was like my first CD. She had like big curly hair. Yeah. Like,
yeah. That music box was
no,
pretty much
that
after
was
that.
That was 90s. This was before that.
Oh man, I've got to show her the
no,
song.
No, like maybe
Eminem
early
disc.
90s.
Oh, the one.
Mariah.
Yeah.
What's that?
Did you love Mariah? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, not now. I like her early days. Yeah,
I'll show you a song later. You're going to...
Yeah, the warning.
It's a warning shot. Blow up your whole spot.
It doesn't do anything to
you. Did you end up listening to the Kamikaze album?
Bits and pieces, man. I couldn't get into it. A couple like Lucky You or Lucky Me. That was okay.
Nah.
The one that you...
Stepping Stone.
Yeah. That was more like what you were saying, like more like him. But the rest, I just thought it was...
Gimmicky.
Yeah, man. Like, and he went, this MGK, you know, Machine Gun Kelly, and what's happening now with the, and then MGK actually released a song.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty good.
I still think it's weak.
But
I finally listened to it.
What, Kamikaze?
Nah.
Oh, MGK. But he's not on the same level. That's the thing.
You haven't listened to a new Eminem, have you?
Mm-mm.
All right. Basically, a week ago, Eminem released an album without telling anyone. Mm-hmm. Right. It was called Kamikaze. And it was like the comeback, you know what I mean? Because his last
album.
No one knew about it. Dude, I didn't listen to his last album. I didn't listen to his album before that. And everyone
was trash.
Everyone's losing their shit over this new album. Like, oh, the king's back and this, this, and that.
Why? Because he hasn't said anything that's all hyped?
Well, the last three albums have been just like, no good.
Yeah, they've been.
The last decent one was probably Eminem Show.
Yeah.
Decent, because it had like a few tracks on it.
When you say not good, like.
No, just he got to, like, Dim will explain, because Dim's more of an Eminem fan, but just gimmicky.
I haven't touched anything since 2012, literally new Eminem. I haven't, yeah? It just started...
Did he get happy?
No, he started becoming gimmicky.
Mm.
He started doing all the chopper flow, like the really quick, fast rapping stuff that is pretty prevalent now.
He was never that.
But, yeah, he was never that. He figured out, like, he could do it, but he started... Every song was starting to take over, yeah? And I lost interest.
Mm.
And what spoke to me was all this really raw stuff. Like, straight hip-hop, Detroit, you know, like, just ground in battle rap.
Dude, his 8 Mile album was pretty good compared to, like,
compared.
You know.
No, this is the problem. He releases this album, right? It's called Kamikaze. And the first thing I thought of was Twista's album, Kamikaze, which is what I put up on Insta. And I said, just saying, man, Twista already released an album called Kamikaze in this style literally fucking 15 years ago. Like... Come on, man.
Maybe it was a shout to him, maybe.
It wasn't.
Bit. No,
it wasn't. No, his whole album cover is an homage to Beastie Boys. Now, this is the problem. I listened to 10 seconds of it.
Maybe he took a bit from everybody.
No,
he didn't. And this is what this album's
about.
It's
got nothing to do with him. No. Like, this is just reminding people that there's already a fucking album called Kamikaze. Like, relax. The problem with this album, in my eyes, is it's more of the same shit. But what he does is this chopper style of rap, which isn't him. It's just become him. And... Trap beats, like, you know, the... Like,
that's SoundCloud rappers, man.
It's SoundCloud rappers. He's making fun of these SoundCloud rappers on the album, but he's utilizing the same sounds all throughout. It didn't speak to me. There was one track that spoke to me, which was more or less his old style talking about D12.
Mm.
Now, like, I don't have a problem with artists embracing new styles and taking new direction.
I was going to say.
That's fine. But when you alienate entire audiences... And, but, like, that's what bothers me.
But creativity isn't about, like, the audience sometimes.
I know,
it's just about you expressing yourself.
This isn't even... That's not even the problem.
Mm.
I was okay with not listening to new Eminem, right? Because I'm an old fan. You know, my tech guy said to me, you're an old fan. You're not a new fan.
Yeah.
You know. But this is what shits me. When people just embrace the work of an artist before they've even... analyzed it and just said, this is brilliant. I was like, dude, you even listen to it? Like, it got released
yesterday.
Yeah,
it's not authentic. It's just...
It got released yesterday and you're already naming it like the best thing he's ever done. Like, relax, man.
Yeah.
Let the dust settle and chill. Like, start...
You got to listen to it a few times
picking
before,
it apart. Like, look at it critically. Look at it, you know, on a whatever level. But it shits me because everyone's, like, lining up to say it's the greatest thing ever and blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, dude... I had someone say to me, you know, oh, you have to hear this, you have to hear that. I'm like, dude, I heard a bit of it. I'm like, that's shit. I don't like it.
Did he message me? And he goes, did you hear it? And I go, it's stock. That's my reply.
It's stock.
This is stock. He can do better. He's better than this.
Yeah. And the thing is, I put someone on blast.
It must be hard for artists, though, to remain
relevant.
He's got thousands
of songs, dude. He's just targeting an audience now. There's no...
Right. But that's
not appealing to yeah. the Eminem fan
base. And it could be his downfall, but I'm just saying that it, you know, must be hard for artists to sort of be creative and be allowed to share themselves, but then almost have to, they're pigeonholed at some point or another. It's, in order to, like in said, order to meet the market about, and be paid for it. You know what I mean?
Look, man, it's not even about being pigeonholed, yeah? Because, I mean, you look at R. Kelly, yeah? I've said this before. I've talked about it
I was listening to his Christmas album.
Yeah, dude, the guy did a Christmas
album. It's not
album.
Even Christmas. Like, I honestly, it's really bad to say, but I really love that cheesy shit.
Yeah, but R. Kelly wrote some of the bad. He wrote
it's
some
the
of
worst.
The filthiest slow jams you've ever heard in your
it's
life.
It's the worst.
Yeah?
I
Crazy
can say
Sex.
That. Yeah.
And, like, oh, he's got 100 songs with the word sex in them, right?
Mm.
And we got done.
And I know, and like, just the shit that's going on with
yeah.
him, like, it's a bit
like, he's
confronting.
Filthy, but, dude,
yeah.
his album, what was it called? Love Letter, remember?
Mm.
And Write Me Back.
No.
That was a straight up 50s, you know, croony sort of album.
Yeah.
It's not about being pigeonholed, right? But it's about making quality freaking music.
Yeah.
So people
yeah.
see through that.
Like, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And it just shit me. Dude, this is what shit me.
Have you seen any interviews and stuff like a...
He doesn't do, like,
no. Eminem.
He doesn't
yeah.
do a lot of...
Not many.
He doesn't do
no.
a lot of stuff like that.
Have you heard of anything, like, since the release of this album Look, that he's come out and said?
Yeah, he's just started to say a few things, but this was my point, right? Every artist is going to have a critic. Like, it's not about that.
Mm.
And as a consumer, I'm allowed to be a critic.
Yeah.
yeah? But what shit me was the amount of people that started calling me
yeah.
a hater.
Yeah.
Because...
The sheep.
I wasn't following yeah. it, falling in line. And I said,
yeah.
hang on. I pulled up fucking rough about this.
Yeah.
I go, hang on, man.
Who's rough?
He's a mate of ours.
R-U-F?
I go, wait a second, mate. I go, how many Eminem tats do you have? I have one. And he went quiet. And I went, that's the point, man. I got this guy's album tatted on my fucking forearm.
Mm.
I'm pretty sure I like his catalog.
Mm.
I just don't like what he's doing now.
Yeah.
And just because I don't like this shit doesn't make me a hater.
Mm.
Like, look, it's the same thing. Like, the way Dim is to Eminem, I'm with, like, pretty Metallica, the old, like, you know.
The old yep. shit.
And, like, when Metallica released Saint Anger, I liked it.
Yeah.
Everyone fucking hated it. It's up to the, you know, the
dude,
person.
Load and Reload were considered...
Dude, fucking hack albums.
Yeah.
Because what happened was Metallica did their Black Album, and that was, like, commercially the biggest... It sold over 100 million albums.
Mm-hmm.
And they went on tour until 94, 95, and then it took a bit of a break, and they came back with Load and Reload, and it was, like, fucking totally different. Like, totally different.
The direction of the albums and the sound, yeah?
People now, if you go into the comments now on YouTube and under the songs of Load and Reload and stuff, people saying this is, like, genius.
Mm.
But back then, they couldn't appreciate
it. I wasn't a Metallica fan growing up, but then this guy got, like, I started listening to him, and then this guy said to me, you know what? And this was only, like, I was still in Clayton, so this was, like, 2012,
yeah.
man.
Yeah.
He turned around and said, you need to listen to the Load and Reload album.
Don't listen to the earlier thrashy stuff.
I reckon you'll like them.
Yeah.
I love them.
Because it's more rock. It's not, like, not fast, just heavy riffs, but clean singing.
And
like,
that's the
yelling.
I happen to love the two albums which...
They're amazing.
People
yeah,
hated.
But the original fan base hated.
And but like when Death Magnetic came out in 2008, I wasn't a fan.
Mm.
But I could sit there and be like, okay, it's not my kind of way.
Yeah.
But the new album they released in 2016, I was like, fuck yeah, man. I like this.
Yeah.
So
no, I get it, but it's I think what's shitting you, like, you shouldn't even let it, because it's like, it's the same demographic that's liking the top 40. Do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
they don't even know why they like it.
The,
it's just
that
it's top 40.
The times have changed now,
and
so
it's you know, that sound that you're saying and whatever, they subconsciously get used to.
You know what's funny, though, but
you know,
if, like, Dre and Eminem and all that came out with an absolute banger, man, it's still, like, kill today. You know what I mean? But they won't do it. They won't do it now.
Before.
And Dre's still releasing his fucking Detox album, whatever the fuck it's
called.
Yeah,
man, that's
it's
been in the works
15 years.
30 years.
Yeah.
Like, seriously.
He started writing it after The Chronic in 91.
Maybe he battled some shit between then, like life.
He has. But
life. What do you mean?
He's the richest rapper
we all
alive.
Do.
I was going to say, sorry, man. I was just going to say, do you guys see the whole thing with Serena?
Oh, yeah, and Mark Knight, the cartoon and all that.
Is it, when you say that, I kind of touch base with it. Is it when she, like...
She blew up on the court.
Yeah, because
the
umpire said that she was cheating.
Well, she was getting coaching from the box.
She was cheating.
That's illegal.
That is cheating, literally.
You can't get coached during game play.
But was it proven? Like, what?
Well, the coach came out. He said, yeah, I was coaching.
Yeah.
Everyone coaches.
The coach came out and admitted it. Are you serious?
Yeah, but does everyone coach?
No. Oh, okay. Well, okay. Let's start from the top.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people are confused about this shit.
Break it down.
All right. Okay. So she's playing the Japanese Haitian girl.
Yeah.
Right?
Naomi Osaka.
Yeah. Is that it? Oh, yeah. It's Osaka.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I kept seeing it. And I kept thinking, why are they naming the city that she's after? Yeah. Oh, no, wait, that's her surname. Right. So she's playing a Japanese girl in the US Open for the finals. And, all right, ref calls time and says, listen, your coaching box is signaling to you, points deducted, right?
Ah.
And she's cracked the shits.
Right? Like, and she was losing at the time.
She was losing.
Too.
Mm. She wasn't winning. She didn't have control of the match to say this was a big shift in the in the nature of the game. You know what I mean?
Mm.
She was losing, right? She cracks the shit. She says, nah, I wasn't fucking cheating, blah, 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 right? Points are deducted.
Mm-hmm.
Then she smashes the racket, yeah? Gets another violation, right? Was it points deducted or just a fine?
I think it was a warning. I think it was a warning.
Yeah? Then she calls the ref a thief.
Because he took a point from her. Yeah.
So he deducted a whole game from
her. And first of all, she was never in control of this
match. No, I think it was a point.
No, it was a game. That was the game by that point.
Oh, but I think when she cracked it, it was like, you took a point from me. Now you're
That's
a thief.
She called him a thief. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right? So she goes on to lose the game, right? The match.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the podium, the Japanese girl is getting booed, right? As if it was like an
outrage.
This
poor girl is 21 years old.
Right? Put it into context, yeah? And this girl's, 21, just beat her idol. Serena Williams was
literally her
idol.
Hero. That was
her hero. Just beat her, made history by being the first Japanese woman to win the US Open, right? And she's on the podium getting booed.
She's in tears. And what does she say? I wish I'd never won.
Yeah.
She said that.
What?
I'm sorry that I won. You shouldn't have to fucking apologize. She I'm sorry that I won.
She won that during the presentation. She said that, sorry.
Yeah.
During the presentation.
People were booing her.
She was getting booed. And then Serena, tries to tell the crowd not to boo and all
that.
Tries
to be the hero.
Yeah, and they make her out, classy act by champion, right? Hang on. It gets better. In the press conference, press conference, she says that she doesn't need to cheat. She'd rather lose. And yada, 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 right? And says she called sexism. She says this is sexism.
She called,
right? She said it was sexism.
She played the card.
She played the card, right? Now, let's jump another day ahead, right? Mm. After that. Her coach was interviewed.
This umpire is obviously getting death threats and shit as well.
Yeah, he's Spanish.
Mm. It's poor cunt. Yeah. Ramos.
Yeah. Of course it's Ramos. Yeah. What else is it going to be?
Enrique Ramos. Yeah. Some shit.
Enrique.
I know his last name's Ramos.
Yeah. Right? Now, Serena's coaching panel have come out and said that, we were signaling from the box, but everyone does it. Yeah,
like everyone. And does everyone do it? And is it okay?
Like, no, it's not. It's a rule. You shouldn't be doing it.
Positive about that?
No, it's a rule. Like, it's actually a rule. You do not coach from the coaching the box.
Okay, if that's the case, then the umpire was right.
Yeah.
And this should be done every match.
Yeah,
but it should be more consistent.
No, there's ways to do it. So this time she actually got caught. Other times, people don't get caught.
If you don't get caught, it's only cheating if you get caught.
Yeah.
Al Bundy.
Well,
it's fucking cheating.
It's only cheating if you get caught, right? But that's the point, okay? He comes out and says, we were signaling, but everyone does it, blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, dickhead, you just played your card there, you muppet. Like, you just showed your hand. You're an idiot, right? But Serena's calling sexism because she says, men get fined for, can get away with more and blah, 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 blah.
But then she brought up all this other stuff.
Do you know what?
Oh, sticking up for women's rights. What does this have to do with women's rights?
Do you know what? That's a good point. She's right there in terms of, men, Ivanisevic back in the day, McEnroe, they fucking just went nuts. Right?
Yeah.
Wait.
Okay.
And they get penalized, but it's like there's no fine line. It's like they let it go and they let it go and they let it go, and then it's they're penalized, right?
McEnroe's been thrown off court.
Okay, but he's had to do a lot to get thrown off court.
Okay, you do remember.
Hang on.
Oh, okay, fine.
So she makes a good point there. What I'm against, though, is that point is not relevant to your fucking thing that you're going through now.
Mm.
And I think that it's a sidetrack. And it's, just like bring them over here so they lose focus is what the real fucking point is. And that's what pisses me off.
She brought up women's rights.
Yeah, it's fucked.
And to a degree, Naomi Osaka didn't get any privileges.
Yeah, it's fucked. Like, she's, she's actually playing a woman as well.
Yeah, that's right.
This is not about women's rights.
You're not playing
Federer. this isn't about sexism.
No.
Like, I get her point, but in a conversation that needs that point. You know what I mean?
If she was upset with what happened, fine, be upset.
A completely different thing that's happening.
Yeah, if she got upset with what happened with the coaching and the point, then go for it. But don't bring up a different agenda.
Like, people are fucking stupid. I'm sorry. People are stupid.
And she goes, I'm going to continue to stick up for women's rights.
Shut up.
Like, what are you talking about women's rights?
On that, Aurora, just in replying to what you're saying, right?
Mm.
John McEnroe and who was the other American?
Ivan Isevich is not an American, but he used to crack it.
They used to crack the shits, right? That was back in the 80s.
Yeah.
Right? Times have changed since then.
Correct.
Times have changed. Correct. Right? And this is the thing.
Correct.
To turn it into a thing about sexism in this, like, moment when this Japanese girl is beating you, beating you.
Dude, she beat her 6'2", 6'4", whipped her.
Not even at this point.
Where a girl who's just created history is now crying on a podium.
Saying, I'm sorry I won.
And apologizing for winning.
What?
Like, seriously?
That girl will never get that moment back again. That's her first grand slam.
You know what I saw?
Yeah.
I didn't even know this whole story. Yet on social media, all, like, the American influencers and actresses and whatever, like, posting shit about Serena Williams, just do it, you're classy, you're awesome, like, fucking lifting her up. And I'm just like, what sheepish, patriotic bullshit.
Okay.
There's a
part two to this, the Mark Knight cartoon. This Mark caricature. Knight is now the biggest
hated guy in the world.
No one even knew who he was.
What?
Harold's son, cartoonist.
Oh, yeah.
He does all the satirical cartoons. He drew the
picture of the politicians and stuff.
Yeah. Mm. He did a cut. Today's cartoon was of Serena Williams jumping like down on her racket and like a dummy next to it.
Mm.
And in the background, the ref telling this girl at the line, at the tennis net, saying, can you just let her win? Right? And Americans, especially, have gone up in arms saying this is racist.
Oh, fuck off.
Hang on.
I can't.
Before you, like, fly off the handle. Just have some more nuts. Soak up some of that wine because we can't lose you this early.
I'm done. I'm out.
Get leverage out.
She's warm. Got her wine. She's fine. No. Dude.
This is my solace right here.
All right. They're losing it because, okay, have you seen the image?
Mm-mm.
All right, hang on, I'll bring it up. Because I had even old Simo messaging me about it. He's an atheist when it comes to sport, his words.
What? A joke. Yeah?
All right, have you seen that?
But no, her cracking the shits.
But that's the best.
And you're a woman saying that.
Yeah.
Right? The headline was Australian artist.
But it's not a thing about sexism, okay, sorry.
Hang on, let me get to the point, dude.
Go.
All right, Australian artist says drawing of
sorry,
Serena
I said
Williams.
Anything.
Really? Really? I love it. She's still holding that glass. That's attached to you. We have microphones and that thing is attached to your hand.
You're going to have to do a whole lot of editing too because I've been munching on this shit.
Oh, good. Thanks.
You're welcome.
You know I start work at 4 a.m. tomorrow, yeah? Yeah. It's for the record, it's what time? 8 o'clock? Yeah, 8 o'clock, I start working
8 hours.
8 hours, yeah. I start working 8 hours, and I live 45 minutes away.
Where are the violins?
All right, man.
Okay, go. Sorry. Okay.
Australian artist's drawing of Serena Williams isn't racist. The world has just gone crazy.
And then Herald Sun released the front page today.
See it?
PC gone nuts or whatever.
Yeah. And the cover of it was this image surrounded by all the caricatures of like politicians and stuff of like the last 10
Trump,
years.
Everybody. Yeah. No one went up in arms when he did one of Trump.
Yeah. And this is the thing, right?
What?
Americans.
Fuckery.
Americans are going up in arms, especially African Americans, because they're saying this is a throwback to like the mammy caricatures of like the 40s and 30s, you know, of black people.
Shut.
Overdrawn big lips, you know, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, please.
And in the background, like,
that's what a caricature is.
Thank you. That was the point. Dude, I literally.
Yeah, it's not big lips because, you know, look.
Serena Williams has big lips.
Yeah. A lot of black people do. Am I racist now? Am I sexist?
Dude,
a lot do. Doesn't
dude,
mean
Mick
you
Jagger
don't.
Has some lips. He's white.
Fuck. It's like saying wogs are hairy. Yeah, a lot of hairy. Like.
Yeah.
Well, dude.
Shit.
Facts.
I started seeing all the feet.
God,
like,
I hate
the,
this piece of bullshit. I hate it.
Dude, I started seeing all the splashback coming in on social media, like on Baller Nation and all that sort of shit.
Mm.
And all these Americans just going nuts, like, oh, Australians are fucking racist cunts and blah, blah, blah. I was like,
literally, that's what American
a whole race.
Yeah. You have a Klansman for a president. Yeah. Like, literally.
Dude, pro-guns and a Klansman.
Dude, he's literally... He was
I think they've done...
the eve of September 11, you had, dude... He came out at Charlottesville and said there were fine people on two sides of an argument. One side, anti-fascist protesters, and the other side, Nazi right-wingers.
I'm just going to say, they think that they think that they're above brainwashing, right?
Yeah.
They're brainwashed.
I know.
Like, it's ironic.
Dude, America's gone to the shit.
The funniest...
What?
The funniest comment was just this one girl, right? And she just wrote, they, all right, because it's... Mark Knight represents Australians. Yeah. We all got together deep hole. Yeah.
You know what? Through this thing. I had a coffee with Mark Knight the other day. And we had a debrief.
And this isn't about, like, countries either. It's about critical thinking.
Deadpool.
This is ridiculous. Dude, ridiculous.
This is a comment. They exaggerated her features so much to make her look crazy and untrue. Mm. Right? I just commented underneath. A caricature is, by definition, an exaggeration of features.
Yes.
Just saying.
Yeah.
Literally. Dude, the actual character... Like, dude, I've got the definition of caricature. A picture description...
I saw that. I was wondering what that was about.
Of a person in which certain striking characteristics are exaggerated now in order to create a comic or grotesque effect.
That's right.
Hence, her physique, her lips, her hair. That's the point of satire.
Hang on, we are saying it's a fucking joke.
It's political. It's social commentary. It's a satire. Mm. We've been doing that since forever.
Yeah. But the now, point is we shouldn't have to defend it.
But that's the point.
Know the meanings. Think for yourself. Stop being a sheep. Stop thinking that you're above everybody else. Like,
America's
fuck.
Lost its way. They've lost their way.
But that's the point.
They don't know what's going
on. And I'm not going to say America's lost their way. A lot of people have. The point is, though, that it's not about American, Australian, whatever. It's like these people that are up in arms about it don't have the ability to critically think about something and reason. They are brainwashed and it's all emotionally fueled. And it's like the people have dropped so many seeds that they subconsciously think that they're consciously thinking of something. They're not.
The irony is this is on September 11th.
And Trump came out and said something stupid about September 11.
That was a joke.
I don't hear it. Great. I don't know about it.
He was up at 6 a.m. tweeting about, you know, collusion and defending himself. And it's funny because they showed, like, all the tweets by former presidents, you know, Obama, Clinton, Bush, all these memorial, like...
Classy.
Really like, classy, deep, heartfelt sort of posts. And then Trump was like, 17 years since September 11th.
Yeah, like, I find tweet. It.
Yeah. That was... You know what I mean? And then
really
we talk
weird,
about
really weird, like
brainwashing.
No, but that's probably his thing about, like, I'm not going to send some sappy post if, like, who knows
he's
what
president.
He knows? Who knows what he knows?
He doesn't know anything.
Who knows? I don't know. But the point is that his advisors have probably gone, send something heartfelt. And he's gone, yeah, this is heartfelt.
Yeah.
And he's tweeted whatever.
Trump operates on another level where he's completely... I mean, people think he's got Asperger's, like, literally.
He may. He's narcissistic.
He's got that... he's displaying that many traits. He's literally...
Oh, he must have had a backlash because he put out a little video. Never forget, September 11th, minute long.
Yeah, there we go. He's got the hands gone as well.
Yeah, he's got the...
Yeah. Fucking Muppet. It shits me because I've got into so many arguments, which is... I'm an idiot. What's wrong?
Okay, just the first comment. I'm not going to read any other comments, but under the video, is Chick Ray the only person in the world who could make a commemorative video about September 11 and make it feel like an SNL sketch?
Yeah, man. It's a joke. Dude, I've wasted so much time, and I'm embarrassed to admit it, I've wasted so much time arguing with Muppets on the internet, especially about race. And it's usually about race defending Australia and Australians, because they make it out like we're the most racist country, and then they start talking about how we treat Aborigines and shit like that. Like, do you people even know who, like, where we live?
Do you know where
live?
That probably stems from?
What?
The fact that we were the last to, like, get on board with equality and... gays and stuff.
We're a young nation.
But I remember, like, the Americans being so up in arms about that and being so disappointed with Australia.
Yeah, but here's the flip, yeah? Mm. Here's the flip, and this is what I've brought it up online.
I'm not saying, I'm just saying
that... No. I understand, but here's the flip, yeah?
Objectively, that's probably where it's
coming from. They've got a president right now. They've got a president...
No, I know.
...who literally is insinuating violence against NFL players and sportsmen because they're kneeling during the American anthem. He's saying they're being unpatriotic and they're disrespecting the flag and they're disrespecting the war heroes and blah, 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 right? This is coming from their president. These sportsmen, sports people, right, they're kneeling to raise awareness to minorities getting beaten by law enforcement and being overlooked. That's what the awareness is.
By Trump and his yeah, administration.
But that's the irony. Like, do you know what I mean? Yeah. They're making this big hoo-ha about a caricature of someone, which is in true to that being a caricature. Yeah. Meanwhile, their president is starting riots over sportsmen and sportswomen yeah, kneeling during a national anthem.
Now, Colin Kaepernick hasn't gone near a field no, since. But he's making... Nike got him on board.
Yeah, that
did
was
you see
great,
the backlash for it?
Yeah.
And then Nike said, you know...
Don't worry about us.
Don't worry about us, mate. We're doing just fine. Everyone's like, boycott Nike. I bought Nike stuff the other day. It's on its way from Amsterdam.
Kaepernick...
I'm yeah, wearing Nike now.
Dude, yeah. Kaepernick got out... They put him on the... It was the 30th... How many years? 50? I think it's 50 years, like whatever it is, their anniversary, yeah?
My
yeah,
brain seizes with this stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty, it's,
this, it's, the thing oh, is, it's relevant.
Can't. No, it's, I get it, it's relevant, but I can't, I, it's like, I don't know. I'm, it's not that I'm above it, it's just that it's so ridiculous to me that I can't believe we're talking about it, that it's happening. It's saddening.
It's a freak show.
It's you know, if I stints, delve too much into it, I lose myself. So I'd rather stay away.
But,
you know,
but you
it's
see
ridiculous,
how much the world gets affected by America's actions?
Yeah.
Do you see what happens? Like, but I think more us so than Europe. I don't think Europe care.
Europe don't give a shit.
They don't give a shit. Like,
well, Europe doesn't have anything to give anybody, so of course
yeah,
they're not.
Yeah, but as in yeah, but yeah, yeah, but like with Australia, it's like we're their little brother kind of thing.
Yeah, because
you know,
we're
so
together.
But we've always been that little brother kind of like. Yeah, it's. Should we become a republic, man? Fuck this.
But that's the point. Like, I feel like we're so underrepresented now. Yeah? I mean, we've got the leadership school, we've got the new prime minister coming
ScoMo.
In. ScoMo. ScoMo. Do you know anything about the new prime minister?
No.
We brought this up
nothing,
last week.
Yeah. Nothing.
I don't know anything about him.
Nothing.
I know he wears glasses.
Yeah.
I know he wears glasses.
But nothing. That's the thing. I don't know anything about him.
To me, it's like when, like, don't get involved in the politics, the whatever. When you come to a decision, when it's like final, when it's okay, when there's a clear fucking line, okay, I'll listen.
We are literally like a lawless country, as in when it comes to politics. We don't know who's running this country.
Dude, do you know who the...
America's running this country.
Yeah, can you name any state premiers?
Well, just ours, Daniel Andrews, because he's got the office next to your place, next to your house.
Oh, yeah.
Next
oh, yeah,
to Mario's no, Pizza.
Who was ours?
It's next to Mario's Pizza. He's the Premier of Victoria. He's got his office next to Mario's.
Yeah.
Killer Pizza.
Darren Hinch. That's who I voted for.
Hinch is Senate. He's a senator.
Hinch is the only one that's got
no,
balls.
No, but
man.
I'm just like, mate, he needs to be Prime Minister. Mate, I like what he's doing.
You know what?
I
he's
like
the only
it,
one that's got balls.
You know what he's
he
got?
Went to prison for
look,
it.
Yeah, man. Because he stood by his word.
Whether or not.
Fuck you guys, man.
Yes, and that's why I like him. It's not about. You might not
massive
agree
alco,
with certain things, right?
Just, massive alco. Why are you clutching the wine bottle?
Because I'm an alco too. Wait, no. I'll erase that.
I like that erase from the record.
No, the reason that I like him is not. You might not agree with every, you know, turn he takes, but the man has integrity.
Absolutely.
And integrity is not a common trait in politics. And it gets in places. Yeah.
And he'll say it as it is.
He says it as it is. He'll go with his word. He'll do what, like, he will accept the rewards and or consequences of his word.
Went to prison.
It's integrity. Yeah. I like that. Yeah, it was for pedophiles.
Yeah.
Especially. It was
he
that.
He named
yeah,
a pedophile.
Yeah. And, like, you know, fuck, well done. Like, he took it in his own hands at the risk of disapproval and backlash and threats. So this is a man that's like, yes, he's got a voice, but it's not the strongest voice. It's definitely not the most powerful. Mm. It's definitely not the most liked. Mm. And he still went with whatever the fuck he went because he believed in it 100%. And he does his research.
Well, they warned him. They said, listen, Darren, you're going to go to jail. He's like, well, come, you know where I am.
Yeah.
Literally, you, goes, know, you look, know where I am.
This is what you like, need. It's not about dictatorship or anything like that. Like, someone like that can take those traits and do negative harm with them. Yeah. But as long as there's a positive thread, I think he'd do really well. So, yeah.
But he's too much on the drink, man. He's got issues, health issues
again. Yeah, no wonder. He's feeling all this.
Liver transplant. Kidney transplant or something. And he's
but this guy is feeling everything and acting. Like the voice of like me who's like, I don't want to fucking know about it. So, I can understand that you're a fucking alcoholic. I get it. I would be too. I am anyway. No, I'm kidding. But,
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to add, like, the sound of a glass being poured.
Yeah.
Just
guys,
the start.
Just a little disclaimer. I'm really not. I'm taking the piss, and I feel like I need to say that.
But
taking the piss? Get it? Oh, punny. Oh, my God. I'm so
it's
great.
It's punny.
You're on your own.
Did you mean to say that?
I don't want nothing to do with this.
This is great.
What's great?
I'm on fire.
We're just tooting your own horn. Are you serious? Hey, you know the kittens bus is just parked outside 7-Eleven?
Darren Hinch to kittens.
No, I'm just saying. I was going to ask you. It says Caulfield in South Melbourne.
Caulfield is gone now.
Is it gone?
Well, I drove past the other day. And I think they were doing like
what
works.
Is there a strippers in Caulfield?
Are you for real?
Glen Huntly Road.
What planet do you live
on, man?
I've
been to a strippers once.
Which one?
You've seen one strip, but you've seen it all, man.
Yeah, that was
someone in
shame.
King Street?
It's about four.
They're all
Men's Gallery. Which one?
Men's, Goldies, Spearmint 21. Stop naming all of them.
Seriously, you've seen one, you've seen them all.
Yeah.
I don't know which one it is, and they asked me what my name was.
What?
They always do that.
You know, they're like, we're talking. Oh. And one was like a marine biologist, you know, day job. Anyway.
Of course she was.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A solicitor, an accountant.
Anyway, yeah. She asked what my name assistant. Was. And you know how they all have fake names?
Crystal.
Mm. Well, Gemma. I was like
Alexis.
Aurora.
Honey.
And they're like, is that your real name? And I'm just like, no, I'm actually, bitch, it's my real name.
Yeah, I'm working tonight.
And you know what?
Yeah.
She probably took that name and went to another strip club and used it.
She's like, that's amazing.
So now there's an Aurora somewhere taking the clothes off for cash.
That name will just pay.
Aurora.
Mm-hmm.
Please.
It's the best name.
Calm down.
It's the best.
Where the fuck did you get that from?
I've come from wanting my name to be Rebecca.
That's no.
What?
Yeah, I wanted the most generic name when I was younger. I hated my name. I hated it.
I bet.
So now me saying I love it, Big Feet.
It's different. It's just.
I love my name.
Because you're not like mainstream generic fucking Bob.
I love it. It's my grandmother's name. Yeah. It served me well. It suits me.
Where did you get Rebecca from?
I just wanted something generic when I was younger, like Rebecca, Stacy, Sarah. You know, like all those stupid names.
No. How are they stupid?
I'm just saying. I'm laughing at myself. No, they're not stupid.
You know what I think is stupid?
I'm just saying they're generic. And
what I think is stupid.
When you're younger, you want to be normal.
These kids get these fucked
was that
up.
Normal? Curly hair up to
I
my fucking ass, Aurora. Like, what the fuck? Everyone pronounces it wrong. You're like.
How can you pronounce your name wrong?
I've had aorta before.
But there's no
A-orta.
T.
Aorta.
There's no T.
Asians, Alola.
There's no L.
But they can't say R.
They can't say R.
Okay, but that's different. That's not because...
This was a boost. You know how you give different names a boost? All right, Aurora. Aorta. This is what they're calling out. I'm like,
that's why you just give random names.
You.
This is why you give random names.
I never say my name at boost now.
Yeah, have a laugh, man. You came up with some ripping names, man.
Yeah. What? Like, you said like
Attila,
Muhammad and...
Blanka. Blanka was good. I gave Glenn once, and they just looked at me like, what?
Glenn.
Glenn, I'm telling you.
That's the best.
Yeah, man.
I wouldn't say stuff like Eminem.
No,
but then they know you're taking the piss.
Yeah, but that's funny.
I've gone through...
Just
I've gone
get
through
him to
phases.
Say it out loud.
I've gone like... You know, Arabic, deep Islamic names, and I've flipped and gone like the whitest name you've ever heard.
Osama?
Yeah, man, keep them on their toes. But they usually, they buckle.
Van Damme.
Like, they're like,
Kenny G.
Claude.
Yeah.
Kenny.
Claude. I've given them random names where they can't pronounce. I've said Methuselah, and they've said.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, Methuselah was a winner. But they won't announce it. They'll look at it. And then they'll think you
they'll
just
be
watch
like,
them.
Strawberry smoothie.
Yeah, they say the drink. Yeah, tropical crush regular with immunity boost. And I'll say it twice, three times. If there's a crowd, I just sort of hang and just wait because, you know, you order a generic drink.
Listen to us heckling. God, it's fun.
Who's heckling?
We're heckling. Awesome. We're like taking the piss, poor people.
Well, say my name. The name's
not
going to get you.
I'm not taking the piss. It's just interesting. It's social experiments.
Yeah. Say my name that I gave you.
Yeah, what's the difference?
No, but see, I wouldn't even do it for social experiment because I know what would happen. But I think it would be more like, this is just going to make my day for a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, like...
Well, it's cool to see someone take their job that seriously or at least respect the guidelines of the job and call out Blanka and Bison, you know.
Yeah.
It's the best.
Yeah.
Blanka.
Yeah, man. Blanka. Dude, I don't like it when parents name their kids something fucking random, like an amalgamation of, like, bullshit words that means nothing that you're going to saddle
I've got a whole list. Not of bullshit words, just of names, like, and they're definitely not generic.
Look, I'm in a big belief where you should be able to name your kids whatever you want, especially as Greeks.
Yeah, 100%.
How there's that whole tradition of having a name your kid after the grandparent. Yeah,
yeah.
A big belief of you name your kid whatever you want. If you want to name him after yourself, go ahead. Mm. But what you can't.
I've
do
actually
is,
thought about it. Is that weird?
What?
I've actually like I would want to name my daughter my name, but more because of It's my grandmother's name.
But after your grandmother.
Yeah, after it served me well. The only reason that I don't is more that confusion.
You wouldn't name her after your mother?
I've thought about it, and I love my mother's name.
That's more of a traditional.
I love my mother's name, but I just, you know when things rhyme and you just can't get it out of your head? And it taints
What's her
it?
Name?
Lydia.
Lydia.
And Lydia, and it's gorgeous, Lydia, yeah. And like, you know, Liddy, it's cute, like you can Lids. Make it short. Lids is her, so Lids. That Lids,
that's
and
a
I fucking
name.
Hate that. Yeah. No, that's what they call it, yeah. Everyone calls
that's
it Lids.
That's a street name.
But it's not like, you know, like,
what up?
I just think
that's
of like, Lydia Chlamydia. Okay. Like, you know, like,
yeah, but it's just you.
Yeah, but these days, it's, you know, it's different.
And more than that, like, I have names that I.
Media. No, but. I didn't think of that.
You're fucked.
But I have. Hey, look, dealing with kids, like, every name reminds you of somebody and or a nickname. And I always think of what that name, that name's nickname will be because there will always be a nickname. I'm Roz, Aro. It's ridiculous. Like, it gets. A Rory, you know, and I'm just like, call me by my name.
But now, like, you work with a lot of kids now, like generic names like Stephen, Andrew. Are they
no, like things
existent?
Like no, but
Stephen.
There's like,
Stephen.
There's actually
Stoive.
Waves.
Stoive.
There's
Stoive.
Waves. And do you know what's funny? A lot yeah, of the mate. Steves, Glens, and whatever yeah. are Asian names now.
Oh, yes,
yeah.
yes, yeah.
But the
Jimmy.
Yeah, but the there's
the
Waves
Vietnamese
like.
Guy.
Sienna, Isabella, Xavier, Elias. What else?
Elias.
Yep.
It's a Greek name.
Yeah. Ilias.
Alexander, Maximus. Like, you know, all of those sorts of things. Like, there's waves of like names being popular.
Yeah, well, because in the 80s and 70s.
Sienna.
Yeah.
You said that twice.
But oh. it's like.
it's cheers.
Like, cheers. I'll drink to that. To Sienna!
you have to name your kid Sienna
it.
Now, that's it.
No, I've got a name. I've got it, like, down pat, and if it's not that, it's mine.
See, if I wanted to name my son something else.
My like, sons I have a tough time with. I've got two names, that's it. A girl's names are like this. Two names for boys.
Well, we came up with Eli.
I like that name.
But we're thinking about Elijah.
Eli,
that's
it. Have you seen Boardwalk Empire?
Yeah, that's
fucking
I don't think
great.
You should watch that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
I
like
love it.
Times.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, love yeah. it. I'm on
Good
to
cast.
Season 4. Did you finish it?
No, I didn't. I
fucking
saw like
great.
A couple of randoms, but I didn't watch it.
Bashimi's
I should.
In it, but it's yeah. really good.
But that's why I want to watch it, because
yeah.
it's Bashimi.
Well, we just wanted something like short and sweet
Eli.
For him.
It's good.
We're thinking about Elijah, and it's like, it sounds a bit punsy. I don't want my kids to be called Elijah.
Oh, see, I like it. Sounds refined to me.
Just Eli, man, just for
yeah, but
Eli's nice.
Dude, look, your name is your name, and you make it what you want to be. Like Chris Brown. Chris
yeah.
Brown is the most boring white person
Chris
name ever.
Brown.
Chris Brown. Yeah, I got an order for Chris Brown. You know, it's the most boring name.
Yeah.
But Chris Brown made it cool.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Dude, it's true. Like, you wear your name.
Yeah, it's your name. You do what you want. But it's when you saddle him with something fucked up.
Have you thought about it?
What, names?
Like kids' names at all?
No, not really. Again, because
it's not part of your
it's something that's never been
current world.
It's just something that's never been at the forefront of my thoughts, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, just because the opportunity hasn't ever even remotely presented itself. So I haven't
yeah, no,
about,
I understand that.
You know?
But I like, you know, I don't know when or wherever I'm going to be a mother, but I had a list from like
yeah,
10 years ago.
Yeah, but that's a priority, as in not a, as
it's,
a priority.
I know that's going to be a part of my life. It's
but
part
you know,
of my purpose.
Yeah, it's on the cards here, whereas
yeah.
I was very negative as opposed to my outlook. Dude, I never thought
yeah,
I'd
okay.
have a job. I never thought I'd have a
okay.
car.
Yeah.
You know? I never
yeah.
thought I'd get to 33 or 34.
Yeah.
Like, it was unheard of.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we wanted to name Eli something else.
Yeah.
I wanted to name him Orion.
I like that name.
Which is, it's got meaning. It's an old Greek ancient thing. It's
like
means hunter
name.
Of the sky.
I like that.
It's ancient. Like, Orion.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's a sick name.
I like
but
it.
But then, you know, we thought about it. I'm like, it's a bit different. Orion.
But see, dude,
no, I like
you want you want a name I love. I love the name Gabriel.
Mm.
Yeah?
Fuck! You're the first person...
Sick name. Gabe.
Who said this?
Gabe.
There were two names on my list. That's one of them.
Yeah.
What's the second one?
I can't say it.
Why? Well, someone's going to steal it.
So now I've got three, including that one.
Oh, thanks. So take a view.
No, because Gabriel was always the initial. I just love it.
Okay,
I just
what do
don't
you actually like
Gabe.
About the name Gabriel?
I don't like Gabe.
You know what? Gabriel sounds majestic.
Gabriel,
man.
Yes.
Well, Gabriel was the
tough, but it sounds tough.
Dude. Gabriel to me is like
a bringer of war.
No, I don't even think it's tough. I actually think it's more refined.
Yeah, but it's got
but it's got quiet
solid
power.
Background. Yeah. It's got.
Am I allowed to elaborate on my why this?
Shut
name
up.
Means
we're having a conversation. Okay.
Seriously? She's halfway through. She's on the way there.
I'm on a roll.
It's like this
Thanks,
episode.
New Zealand.
This episode needs a disclaimer. It's like, welcome to That's Not Right podcast, featuring Nick Aurora and a bottle of wine. You know what I mean?
This week's bottle of wine is from New Zealand.
Sponsored by Kiwi. Curious no, Kiwi.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like,
it's very appropriate.
I brought it up. I didn't even get the
Gabriel.
Finish.
Sorry, go. Gabriel,
this one's
go.
Gone off about how much it means to her. Like, relax.
Just talk.
Okay. I like Gabriel. The name Gabriel means the messenger, mm-hmm. Christ's messenger, right? Okay. And I like that. It's like Azrael, like on my back, yeah? Azrael was
like a guide,
archangel of death.
Yeah.
I'm not a religious person, but I like the meaning behind it, right? Mm-hmm. Gabriel was the messenger of God, okay? Yep. So I like that, you know,
his
fucking
stance.
Meaning, right? Even though I don't fucking believe any of that shit, but like, I like that, yeah? But for me, it's not even the word name Gabriel. It's the Greek pronunciation of Gabriel.
How's that?
Gavril. Right?
Oh, okay.
It's pretty similar in Arabic as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Very Israeli kind of like.
Yeah.
Kind
say it again.
Gavril.
Yeah.
And the reason why that means something to me.
Dude, does that sound?
Do you know who? Do you know, for me, Gabriel, it wasn't even Gabriel, it was Gavril. It was a guy when I was a kid, I was like 5 or 6, we had family friends that used to own, it was like a Guinnessy, like a restaurant tavern that turned into a club up in Sydney Road, you know where all the Arab joints are now. Yeah, they owned one of them there during the 70s and 80s. And they shut shop pretty much when I was young, I would have been like 4 or 5, like no later than that. I can't imagine being much older than that, because it was just when I sort of come into awareness.
Mm.
And we used to go there and just...
How cute.
Yeah, dude, to go there, black slacks, white shirt, you know, bow tie.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we'd go there on Saturday nights, right? Just to, you know, be there or whatever.
White chocolate.
Dim would be sitting behind the bar mixing drinks.
As a kid. Johnny Red, Black Douglas. Yeah. That's it. But there was a guy,
This show is built on caricatures, can I just say?
It is.
Yeah. Anyway, yep, go.
Because that's just taking the piss. It's just understanding and making light of a shitty situation.
Yeah.
Yeah, the guy, there was a guy that ran the house band there, right? Mm-hmm. And he was like a singer, dancer, he could dance like Michael Jackson, it was so fucked up. But I had a video of him when I was a kid, and I used to watch this video of him like doing his thing. Mm-hmm. And he was one of the first people to introduce me to musical instruments. I remember I walked over to where the house kit was set up, showed me the drums, and he'd fuck around his guitar. He was literally like one of the first dudes I ever met that was like a triple threat sort of guy, you know, sing, dance, and I was a kid. I can't imagine it would have been much older than 20. Like, he was a young dude. I don't know. But to me, he just seemed like the coolest rock star I've ever met in my life, yeah?
Yeah.
And I just remember thinking, this guy's the coolest motherfucker ever. No, legit. I was like 4, man. Like, I was a kid. But I'll never forget the guy's name, ever. I don't know who he is. I don't know what happened to him. Guy could be a wino at Flinders Street. I got no idea.
Mm.
But that, you know, for that little brief period where I can actually came of age in my head and awareness, I still remember him being the slickest fucking cat.
Mm.
In, you know, in Sydney Road.
Yeah.
So
it's a tough name. It's a really nice name.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Yeah.
So what's the other names?
Don't make fun of them, though. Don't make fun of them. Wait, if I tell you, you can't make fun of them. Like, shit all over them. Pretend I had a child and named him this, okay?
Yeah.
Wait,
one was...
Gabriel.
Okay, so that's off the table.
I love...
Yeah. Yeah, man, that's sick.
I love it, Sister to me has spunk, like a little charisma, and like cool.
Play the jacket, looks like a greaser.
And the other one that I really love is
that's the whitest name in the world.
I love it. I love it. I just said, don't make fun of it.
That's the whitest name.
Shut up.
I'm not making fun of it. I'm just saying.
No, I really love it.
That kid will be born a lawyer.
Yeah, where did you get that?
I love it. I love it. In Italian, I hate it in Italian. See, in French,
Would he be born on the birth certificate?
No,
the Italian.
It'd be. And I had like the I'm really big into, like, the middle name as well. Mm. So I like the combination of...
That just says fashion designer.
Yeah. No, that says lawyer, strong, not even lawyer. Like, that says quiet power. That says I'm together. That says I'm a gentleman.
Yeah, everything I want, like, overcoats.
That sounds Illuminati.
That says I want
an overcoat, dude, a trench and a cap, a fedora,
yeah,
small
love
pistol.
It. Yeah.
Nothing big.
Like a Clark Gable or something.
Yeah, love
like
it.
Old 40s, 50s yeah. kind of feel.
I fucking love it. Yeah.
Do you know who that is?
Yeah, hang on, let me find it.
It's that quiet sense of power that's like, I'm together.
Strong name.
It's strong and that, but not
crystal,
strong.
Crystal
not
Becky.
Strong like, look at me. Like strong like, understated, but... Yeah. Cemented. I like that energy around a name.
Oh, where the fuck is it?
Yeah.
I had this saved for ages, maybe deleted it by accident or something.
There's a few others, like, now that I think about it, yeah, okay, I've had a few others.
Mm.
And
it's
some
hard
of them
though,
are really, and I think the thing is, like, these are just names on a list, but I'm going to meet this soul and really see
you'll
what it's...
You'll know as
yeah.
soon as you see this
yeah.
kid.
Yeah, and I know I will.
You'll know.
I know I will.
Dude, you reckon.
Yeah, we had a few
yeah.
names. We probably dwindled it down to three.
Yeah.
And as soon as we saw him, we're like, yeah.
Yeah.
And that was it. Like, we knew straight away.
What would you do if you were in a stalemate? I'm just hypothetical.
And with my partner?
Like, whoever you've had the kid with, yeah?
Can I just say?
Deal breaker.
Hey, I'm
Jim.
Having said this, like, I'm a person of reason.
Really?
Yeah. What do you mean, really? Are you serious?
Fuck. Get the arms out.
Are you serious?
You serious right now, boy?
Yeah, so, like, but... In terms of this is what I've... Because I'm so... Like, I've lived for this
aggressive,
moment, right? I've lived for this
one-eyed,
moment.
Arrogant.
I've lived for the ability to have babies
to
and
it.
Stuff like that. And so I've just gone, hey... Like, I can weigh up how much does my partner hate it as opposed to how much I love it. And that's how I weigh it up, right?
Is the decision going to come to you, though?
But if this is like a 40% hate and a 60% love, you're fucking outvoted. I don't care. I've pushed a baby out of my vagina. Fuck you. This is how it's going. I don't care.
You know
like,
what?
This is something non-negotiable.
You will.
Unless you're 10% and I'm 100.
No,
then I will reason it out. But... In regards to this,
in
it's
most
like,
cases,
learn to love
it's not
it
like
because...
that. In most cases, it's not like that,
yeah.
honestly. When
I'm like,
it, when
this
it comes
is my
down
thing.
To it,
don't take this away from me.
But me and Ren, like, when she was probably about 4 weeks out, we were, like, you know, going through names properly. We were actually analysing names and, you know, not so much
Did
analysing.
Did you have the same names?
Roughly.
Yeah.
Roughly. Like, she liked Elijah and I said,
okay.
I just don't like.
See, I like that because that was a compromise, and both yeah. names are beautiful.
Yeah, and then there was a couple of other ones, but yeah, we just ended up. But we picked out the letter E.
Yeah.
Because of her dad.
Okay.
I'm just picturing that classic scene in one of those romantic comedies where they're like the couple is sitting there with like their fucking notes, and the guy's like going through the names, and she's like vetoing all of them, like rubbish. Nah. No, 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 no. So he's like puts his shit down. He's like, all right, so just give me one name, and then she says one. He's like, I don't like it, and then she just
see.
Like,
I don't.
Using
I don't
shit.
Picture
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
I don't think it's a power play, and it shouldn't be. For me, it's like just give me the gift
yeah.
because it's so important to me. Like,
well,
it's not. This is a situation where it's like, hey, mate, you want to exercise your power? Do it somewhere else, not in this. Yeah. Like, make an unconditional love in this energy. Like, just give me what I want because
you
I'm not a
right
demanding
decision.
Bitch.
You
and I demand
up,
this.
Look, you end up making the right decision. I look at Eli now and I think there's no other name I could have named him.
Yeah.
I look at him now and that's his name. That's
I
him.
I think that's the thing. Like,
so
I know I'll feel that too.
Same
like,
with a dog. You know, I name a dog.
Dog.
I know that I'm eventually going to buy a German Shepherd because I love German Shepherds.
Yeah.
A black German Shepherd.
My dad too.
And I'm going to call it Bronx.
Yeah, cool.
I've always wanted to name my dog Bronx.
Do you know what? If I've ever got a dog, I know the name. Sir Camelot.
You're
going to call your dog
Sir Camelot?
Yes.
Your dog will have been of knighthood.
For sure. I'm going to
call
him
Sir Camelot. Sir Camelot. And I'm going to name him Sir for short. So cute.
Sire.
I always said I would name my first dog Megale. Megale means... Megale means big boy.
I just think of the guy on the commercial.
Manga.
Not Megale.
Yeah. Kakakotsu doing his thing. Nah, dude, I would name it Megale, and I'd go get a tiny little fucking Jack Russell name Chihuahua or something.
Call him a Aliti.
If you're in the park screaming, it's like, hey, Megale! The dog comes running out.
Cool.
You never lose your dog.
Nah.
I'm like, sir, Camelot.
Sir Camelot? That looks like you're a lunatic.
Yeah, why?
It's his little fucking teacup dog.
Yuppie.
Yeah. No, designer fucking like, schnauzer.
I love the chow chows and all the huskies.
I hate these designer dogs. Chow chows and
huskies.
You know what? It's difficult to have a husky.
I know. That's why I don't have a dog.
Is that husky Clayton?
Yeah.
Running the old lady's house.
Yeah.
Dude, that fucking center road.
The guy has like, what, 4 or 5?
I haven't been down that way in ages, so.
Yeah, but he had, like, I remember that corner house. Yeah. He had like 4 or 5 huskies.
You know, the corner of Springs,
that's annoying.
Springs Road and Center Road, yeah?
No, like, if I'm not.
They looked well looked after. They looked like.
Dude, the backyard was all concrete.
Yeah, there's no grass.
The area literally as big as this.
Far as the eye can see.
Yeah, but in summer. They'd be outside. These dogs need...
Sitting there next to the cars.
But they need ample room.
Dude, that,
sorry, a house in Clayton.
That corner would be one of the most congested corners in Clayton.
Didn't cut it. Not that.
Dude, fucking smoke would be puffing out of their fucking ears.
Dude, I had 2 dogs when we were in Clayton. I had a big backyard.
Your backyard was the size of 3 properties, man. Yeah. It's huge.
So, but that was like not enough for those huskies. I feel sorry for them.
Yeah, no, me
the size
too.
Of this room, but it's all concrete on the corner, a main intersection.
Yeah, there are dog owners that shouldn't be dog owners.
No.
I was just going to bring up. Have you heard? You've gone through the Sopranos series, right?
Yeah.
Do you know how he named his boat?
The boat that he
Stugatz?
Yeah, the best word.
I love it. So that's what we should do: is name our dogs
what,
like
Stugatz.
Balls and Stugatz. These balls.
Balls.
The games.
Yeah, the dude, best. Balls. I thought I saw that and I'm like, oh my god.
Yeah. So I'm going to call my dog Adhidia.
Yeah, bad.
Adhidia. Just one ball. Adhidia.
You discriminate your dog a ball. Yeah. Yeah, what's wrong with that?
No, I don't. I'm saying that that's how it should be.
Jesus Christ.
Either that or Sir Camelot.
Why Sir Camelot?
It was an inside joke, and it just stuck.
And now it's
so
it's
no. Whenever like I think how it happened was someone was being prissy, or they said something in a prissy way, and I'm like, oh no worries, Sir Camelot, and I just sort of went with it. So now that I ended up calling that person like Sir Camelot because it was so prissy, and
you
I was like, I love that
Cam.
Name.
Yeah, Cam.
No.
You get tired of saying Sir Camelot.
Cam wrong.
No, Sir. It'll be Sir.